Hitting record on a practice and work session already in progress today by an hour or so. Pretty warmed up here, and I've been working on a transcription for an arrangement, transcribing the melody to this Mute Math tune. A band called Mute Math. I'll play a tiny clip. Okay, that's about all I can get in the video, but Mute Math is a tune called Noticed, and arranging it for instrumental ensemble, and got most of the melody down now, and I'm gonna start working on reharms. I just want to play the melody kind of over and over and over again. Changes. Changes there, but I'm just working on the reharm. I don't want to get too far away from the song. I don't want to start out. I can't get too complicated too soon. I want to state the melody so it's kind of recognizable. To do here to strike that balance. I don't like all those changes in there. Could have one of those. go like that. Mola. Yo. Mola, mola, mola. Yeah, having said, I'm not going to go crazy with the harmony initially. Of course, that's the first thing I'm doing. But this is actually good that I'm hearing this stuff right now, because that will work great down the line for reharm. So maybe we're really just stating, state the melody super clean up front. And we're going to change the feel a little bit. It's very much like that, like straight eighths. So, some kind of riff like that up front. So far, I think. So now let's work out a reharm version of that, and I can A B the two perhaps, and get this B section as well. Actually, who am I kidding? I'm not doing this for the monetization, let's face it. So let's get these changes for the pre-chord. Five.
Thank you.
Okay, so okay, so we have that. What's this feel? Pre-chorus straight. So let me try and get the pre-chorus and the verse and the pre-chorus. Three immediately I forget it. What the... change the form on this a little bit as well. Maybe not go to the chorus right away. Maybe a verse and a pre. Okay. Let's see if I can get it right this time. Thank you. Okay, now let's expand to the chorus. Oh, it's just 1/5. There's one more chord in there. Oh, four again. Okay. Okay, so there's some extra bars in there. So now we've got to try and get the whole thing in it. Okay, let's get rid of that and let's just practice the chorus. Maybe it ends up only being the verse that gets a little bit of reharm. Now I'm gonna have to go back and look at this video because I can't remember the rehams I came up with. But at least I have those on record, and now I'm going to try and put the whole form in there. How is this? The form at least. Come to some agreement on three halves. Some things here. Switch to the piano and do some reharm work and some voice leading and try and get away from the bass and not make the bass be like the dominant feature in the voice of the writing. It's good to get onto something that I have a weakness in, like piano, and have it not be so bass dominant. But yeah, that's sort of typical for an arranging session there, or transcription, melody, arranging, figuring out bits and pieces and parts, and getting on the road to for this production. I'll talk a little more about what this is for at a later date when we get close to the time. But yeah, I'm psyched about it. It's gonna be fun to record some pop music and make some hip arrangements and some hip changes, but not get too far away from, you know, from what the song is about and the melody and the diatonic nature of it. I don't want to get too far away from it being a great tune the way it is. Yeah, so that's it for today's. See, that's the other thing. I wish I now had just as much time as I'd spent doing that to sit down. And practice. Even though the chops are feeling pretty loose, I gotta say. Not too many clams. Pretty good. So maybe it's not a tragedy that I don't sit here for another hour and practice, but it would be super nice. But that is yet another reality of the situation and my day and the schedule, and shall continue to try and rectify that and bring more balance to it as I go. See you guys on the... Hey, before I go, if you made it this far, don't forget we are counting down to the launch of Oh man, I wish I had my printed copy here, but we're counting down to the launch of the Bass Player's Guide to Looping. That is less than a week out. You can still get a 25% discount. Everyone who pre-orders, I'm giving a 25% discount on the price of the book too. That is this week. We are in November of 2019. Book launches on Black Friday, November 29th. So if you're watching on YouTube, there's a link below this video. If you're listening on the audio podcast, you can go to my store and it's an instant discount. You don't need a code or anything. It is just discounted by 25% for all pre-orders. It's on the homepage of my store. Thanks for sticking out. I think we're up to episode 11 here in a row. This is good. I like this consistency. I like the ease with which it goes up online, and there is zero, as you can tell, editing on this thing. So yeah, see you cats, coffee drinkers, bass players, musicians on the next one.